Dear advisees, welcome to my presentation on how to use the advising file. I named it as a Musharraf. Dear advisees, you have to update this file mainly 3 times in a semester. In the beginning of the semester, in the middle of the semester, and in the end of the semester. In the beginning of the semester, you have, that is after the timetable registration, you have to choose this option, studying. Whereas in the middle of the semester, that is to choose the courses for the next semester, we call it as projections, okay, you have to choose this option, next semester, okay. So for convenience, put the yellow color on the next semester. Whereas at the end of the semester, you convert all the studying cells into the pass or fail based on the results. Is this clear? Beginning of the semester, studying. Whereas to choose the courses for the next semester, you have to go for the next semester. Whereas at the end of the semester, once the results are announced, pass or fail, we have to update. Okay, so let's open our advising file. Okay, so here is the file Musharraf. Okay, so this file consists of 3 sheets, one for biology specialization, another one for chemistry, and the third one for environment. Okay, so let's see the structure of this sheet. Okay, so this is having, first of all, you should write your ID and name here. Okay, yes. Then look at the 4 columns. The first column is the level, then this is the course code, this is the course name, and this is the very important column, that is the status here. Okay, so look at here, this is diploma year 1, diploma year 2, like this, advanced, the BTEC. Okay, now, so here we have 2 types of cells. Some cells, they are empty cells, white cells, blank cells. Whereas on some cells it is written not eligible, like this. So for example, in the diploma year 1, total 11 courses are there. Out of 11 courses, 3 courses, on 3 courses it is written not eligible. Why it is not eligible? Because these courses have some prerequisite. For example, to know this is technical writing 2, so it is written not eligible. Okay, so just click here, you come to know, okay, what is the name, what is the prerequisite course, technical writing 1. Until the student clears the technical writing 1, this will not change. Okay, you are not supposed to take this course. Okay, now, so for example, chemistry 1, it is showing not eligible because fundamentals of chemistry, this should be passed, then only it will change. Okay, like this. So there are some connections, so to know them, okay, look at here, come back to here, technical writing 2. So just either you put the cursor, okay, or simply double click. If you double click, this part is highlighted, so technical writing 1. So like this, they are connected each other, 2 cells are connected each other with some formula, conditions are given, okay, whatever it may be. So once you open the formula, okay, press escape, otherwise the formula will change. Okay, press escape. Okay, now I will show you. So here, these are the empty technical writing 1, empty box cell is given. Okay, then this empty cell is given with a drop down. This is called a drop down. Okay, so this drop down, if you press this one, so some 5 options are opened here. Okay, pass, studying, next sem, withdraw, fail, like this. Clear? Okay, suppose you join this department. Initially you take, suppose you joined in semester 1, you have to take 5 courses. Then what you have to do, you have to choose studying one course. When this is studying, what is the response of this technical writing to, it is converted into next sem. Suppose, let's see, delete this one, delete. See here, it is showing again red, not eligible. Okay, so when this is studying, the response of this cell is next semester. Okay, it means now you are studying technical writing one. In the next semester, you may, okay, we assume that you will clear this subject and in the next semester you will take this course. Okay, so this next semester will be used for the projections. Okay, suppose if you pass this course, pass, yes, immediately next technical writing 2 is converted into eligible. Eligible means now you can study this course, technical writing 2. Clear? Similarly, look at the behavior of, okay, for example, chemistry 1. Okay, what is the prerequisite? Fundamentals of chemistry, press escape. Okay, when you, for example, if you put the studying here, this next semester, okay, not only this one, even this is also organic chemistry also responding. Like this, cells are connected to each other, accordingly you have to plan. Okay, so let's see. Okay, like this you have to study slowly, one after another. Okay, based on the conditions you should study. Okay, so you can delete, no problem. After choosing, suppose you have this is studying one, suppose one more course, two courses, three courses, you are four courses, which can you take technical writing two? No, because prerequisite is technical writing one, you cannot take this course. So four courses, for example, you are studying this environmental studying. Okay, so five courses you are studying now. Okay, suppose after the registration, I told you this is the way we have to follow. In the beginning of the semester, we have to go for studying. Okay, so the advisor asks you, okay, maybe around after the mid examination, the advisor asks you what courses you want to study in the next semester. Then what you have to do, the system will automatically show some courses next semester. If you want to study them, okay. If you don't want to study, that is also okay. Okay, suppose you joined in semester one you have to take 5 courses, whereas you have to choose 5 courses for the semester 2. Okay, let's choose 5 courses for the next semester. Okay, the system is already showing next semester. Suppose you want to choose it, put some yellow color. One course you have selected. Suppose you want to study physics. Okay, go for, okay, this is, see, empty means you can take it at any time without any condition. Not eligible means they have some conditions like this. Okay, suppose physics you want to study, first you choose next semester, then you put yellow color. So two courses you have selected. Same thing for lab technique, next semester. Okay, put yellow color. Okay, yellow color, because the system, see here, why we are putting the yellow color, because sometimes the system will show so many next semester. Okay, so we cannot study maximum 5 courses we are eligible. So out of these many, next semester only we are choosing the selected one. So on them we are putting the yellow color. Suppose we want to study chemistry 1. Okay, now entrepreneurship is not eligible. Okay, we are going for the SLOM. Sorry, next semester. Okay, put yellow color. Like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 courses. Okay, so you can choose your courses for the next semester. Okay, so inform these next semester, the yellow one, to your advisor. Okay, Is this clear? Okay. So middle of the semester you have chosen the five courses for the next semester. Clear? You understood the second point? Now go to the end of the semester. What you have to do at the end of the semester? End of the semester, once the results are announced, what you have to do? You have to convert all the studying cells into the pass. Okay, pass or fail based on the results. So I want to take it as okay. I randomly will check. Suppose this one technical rating one pass. Okay, so for example, advanced IT also pass. FOB also, for example, pass. For example, FOC fail. Look at here. What will happen to chemistry one? Have a look at chemistry one. Okay, so suppose this is fail. Chemistry 1 is going back to not eligible. Okay, got it? Okay, you have selected for the next semester. Okay, chemistry 1 unfortunately fail. So fail means it will come back again. You have to study, so it is back. Okay, like this. Okay, suppose FOE is, for example, pass. Like this, you will be maintaining your record. Okay, you finished your first semester. Okay, this is the result: pass, 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 fail, pass. For example, like this. Now, when the second semester comes, what you have to do? Obviously, your first priority will be fail course. Again, when the new semester starts, this is the rule. Beginning of the semester, middle of the semester, end of the semester, like this. Beginning of the semester studying, middle of the semester to choose the next semester courses, put on yellow color on next semester, and end of the semester based on the result, pass or fail, like this. Okay, clear? Now suppose second semester after the registration, okay, you have to choose studying. This is one studying. Okay, so this is eligible, he is saying. Okay, we already selected technical writing 2. Okay, now what we have to do? An important step. Okay, one important step, the legal step I want to explain. Eligible. Okay, once the cell converts into eligible, you have the chance, you can do one thing. Okay, this is called empty drop down. This symbol is called drop down. Okay, take any drop down, either pass, fail, or you go for any empty drop down. Empty, this is called empty drop down. Okay, copy. Okay, paste it on eligible because we are going to study it now. Paste. Okay, make it as okay. Only one place it is valid. Wherever eligible comes, put the copy paste the drop down. Empty drop down. Okay. Okay, so technical writing, do you want to study now? Now what you want to study? Physics also you can study. Lab technique also you want to study. Okay, so you cannot study this next semester. Okay, because you are studying the FOC now. Okay, so you planned for next semester because as you failed in this course FOC, so now you cannot study. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and yes, this is also a drop down. Okay, this is not the drop down, this is the formula. Okay, you cannot study this. Okay, so this is studying. Clear? So in the middle of the semester. Okay, like this you have to follow continuously. In one semester, 3 things you have to do. Okay, so the same thing for chemistry. Okay, this is for chemistry specialization students, this is for environment specialization student. Okay, I hope you understood. Okay, if you have any queries, you can write to me. Okay, So these are the guidelines to use the file. Whatever I explained, the same thing. And these are the guidelines, okay, not to do, what you should not do. Okay, don't delete any formula, don't add any rows, delete. So this is a very sensitive Excel sheet. Okay, so here what you have to do, you have to just update this one, update this part. Okay, don't do anything. So this part, okay, is very important for us. Okay, if you want to write anything, you can use this part to write, suppose to go to the next level, what are the conditions, all this one. Okay, if possible I will write here any other conditions, otherwise you can write it. Okay, so I hope this Excel sheet will be useful for you. Okay, all the best.